Lighting Without Wires, Darwin's Lighting Without Wires, with Michael Groves. Michael, welcome. Happy Thanksgiving.
Thank you very much, Jim. Happy Thanksgiving to you too. Great. So I wanted to talk to a bit about how do you really light buildings? And one of the things I'm going to start with is I've got this really nice looking German railroad station, right? So that's what we're going to start, what we're going to work on for the next 3 weeks. But I want to show you a bit of a challenge first as to what happens when you light buildings. So, and I've seen this happen numerous times. So I'm going to take up one of these plastruct buildings and I'm going to take one of my lamp lighter, turn it on, and I'm going to stick some fiber up into here. I don't know if you, can you see what's going on that roof there?
Yes.
Well, that's a bit of a pain. And so I get customers who send me pictures and there's a glow on their roof. And I go, no, that's not good. So we're going to start right at the beginning as to the first thing I need to do on that roof line. So now I've got this good German building. And of course, as I look at their roof line, again, I'll just dim the lights. Thanks, Shirley. You can't see any light there. Uh-oh, you can right along the top, right?
Yep.
Right along the top. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to take some aluminum foil. So I just grab some out of my wife's cupboard. Very simple. Take that, and I'm just going to cut down some what I think will be about the right width of it. So I've got a shiny side, and obviously I've got the dull side. Well, I'm going to put the dull side against the roof. So what I can do is, in fact, fold that in half. So I'm going to take that piece, and actually I'm going to move this down a bit so you don't see as much of me, but you see more of my hands. That's more interesting. Okay. So naturally, we're going to take that roughly in half, not quite, and we'll see if we stick it up into the roof line. Excellent. Okay. Well, it probably needs a little bit of sticking power. So what I use, I often use just something like this. Tacky glue, very, very simple. So all I'm going to do is just put a couple of tacks down on the roof line. All right. And of course, because foil is very, very light, I really don't need that much of it on there, of the glue. Okay, good. So I just sort of tacked some on. You're going to see, actually, I've got a bit of a protrusion here. So that's going to create a bit of a problem. But the great thing about foil is it's so light and bendable, that probably won't make a bit of much difference. So good. So now I've got my roof stuck on there. Good. So very simple. All right. So there's two reasons you really want to do something like this. One is, obviously, you don't want light coming through the roof. Two, it makes sure all the light comes back into the building. Well, okay, good. So because really, we don't want, people have asked me, well, why don't I paint it black? Well, that's a great idea. The problem is when it's painted black, it's going to absorb all the light. And it's kind of a shame to throw light away when, in fact, you'd like the light to be in there. So that's number one. Number two, I've made a decision on this building that actually I don't want to see inside those windows, but I do want to see inside my little bay window. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to frost these windows up and leave my bay window completely open, and you'll see why in a moment. So what do I use for that? Well, I just take some paper, and it's really just parchment paper, or this actually is paper that you can print on your printer, and I've just marked a couple of lines on it, and that'll allow me to snip, 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 and get the right lengths. And again, I'm just going to apply some glue. So I think I'll take the longest one that I've got. And I'm just going to literally put that onto the building there. It's a little bit long. So nice thing about this stuff, you can cut it so easily. Done. Right. Let's see if it's the right size now. Yep. Perfect. All right. So I'm just going to put some dobs on there. So again, we're doing this in absolute real time. So,
Michael, why did you use the paper there instead of the aluminum foil?
Oh, okay. The reason for using the paper is because I really would like some light to come through. So let me put the paper there. Yep. In fact, let's just do this. So now I'm just going to take some light. I'm going to shine it up. See the effect? Whereas if I have it right here, we're going to see the fiber and we're going to see everything. We really don't want to see that. Whereas here, we've got now just a very nice diffuse light. Does that make sense?
Yep, absolutely.
So that's what we're going to do. And I'm just going to do that.
Aluminum foil would block it totally.
Absolutely. Aluminum foil would block it completely, which is fine if you really don't want to see through the windows at all. So I'm just going to pop some glue on all of these. So you can see how quick it is just to do this sort of stuff. It's very quick. And of course, it really doesn't have to adhere in a sort of a very precise way.
Michael, does bond paper work for the diffusing the light the same as the kind of paper you're using? Or is it that special printer paper that's necessary?
No, you can use parchment paper. You can use tracing paper as well. But bond paper is not going to be transparent enough.
Okay.
So I wouldn't use bond paper on it. So that's our most fundamental thing to do. So let's now put this light up into here. The back of the building. Yep. Okay. Good. And so on. So now I've started to get my building ready. So the next step that I'm going to take is I want to start thinking about what am I going to do with this bay window. So what I did was, you're very familiar, obviously, with foam board. Foam board's easy to work with. So what I do is I've just cut up a couple of pieces. I've cut one up for the roof line. I cut another one for the roof line, but I put a little ledge on the back of it. You'll see why. So I'm going to take my building, and I always get myself mixed up here as to which way I want to put this in. Oops, I put it in the wrong way already. So, yeah, there's only two ways to put it in, and I started the wrong way. Excellent. Okay. So there inside is my little room, and all I need to do is to complete it. I will glue this on in a moment, but I need to just put that part in, and I'm going to have my room. Obviously, it's a bit wonky at the moment, but I will glue that in place. So that's going to be kind of interesting. I'm going to actually want to put something on this surface here. So I've actually got, and it's easy to get these, pictures of insides of buildings. So I'm going to scale them down to the HO size, and I'm going to glue them on the inside of this little frame the frame here, so that it looks like the inside of a station. I might put a chair or two in the inside as well, because that way I'm going to actually have something that we can look at on the inside. Key part will be, and we'll talk about this much more next week, is how are we actually going to light that? In fact, how are we going to light here and how are we going to light there? And to introduce you to that topic, I'm going to grab a piece of information that we use at our shows all the time. And of course, there we go. I think you can see the fiber.
Yeah.
So if I was working on a big O-gauge building, I might use 2mm fiber. It's pretty darn ropey. If, on the other hand, I'm working with an HO building, and I want to light all of it, I could use a 1.5mm fiber. And we'll actually experiment with that next week, doing that. And we'll probably see that what we want to use is a 1mm fiber, because these rooms now have become quite small in this HO building. So we'll look at selecting the right sort of fiber for getting the lighting right. But the other thing we're going to need to do is we're going to think about how do we get the light and get it so that it really shines onto that surface. Now, I'm just going to give you an example of what I mean by taking a church building. Now, this church building has paper on it. So this is this problem where you've actually got something that's pretty opaque, like a sheet of paper. And if you try lighting this building with typical LEDs, you won't get very far with getting light through the windows. If, on the other hand, I take something like a fiber and I stick it up into this building, now you can see, I've not put any foil on the side of the on the walls, so we're getting a lot of glow through the walls, which I don't want. But the fiber does an excellent job because it's much more directional. And that's what we're going to use on the inside of that other building, so that you actually then see beautifully into it, and it just, we're going to reflect off the images that are inside it, and you'll really get a whole lot of detail out of it.
Going back to the paper that you use to diffuse the light,
yes.
Can I use wax paper, just normal wax paper that my wife uses in the kitchen?
Yep, you can use wax paper. All I do is just sort of hold it up to a window and see, yeah, am I got enough light? What do you think, Shirley?
My wife? I wonder if she has some parchment paper.
Parchment paper's even better.
I got you, parchment paper. Okay, I see what you're saying. The other question I've got is, putting the light in there, you are going to light the total building, aren't you? I mean, is just one fiber going to light the total building somehow, or just individual rooms?
All right, that's a question that we will answer next week, but I'll answer it very quickly now. That's fine, Jim. We've actually partitioned it now into three complete compartments, and the light is not going to leak through very much from one to the other. So we are going to use multiple fibers, but not nearly the same size as we would if it was just a single building with no partitions in it. But adding partitions really gives some interest to the building.
Jim, two other thoughts about how you can diffuse light through the windows. One is, with very fine sandpaper, you can sand the glazing. That works sometimes when you're doing like the windows into a bathroom or something like that. And the other one is to spray the glazing with dull coat.
Huh. That's a great idea. I like those. Here, though, many of these buildings don't have any glass or anything in them, so you're left with just space.
Are you putting glass in your bay window?
No, not putting any. I won't put any glass in at all. I don't need to, because that'll just act as a reflector when I've got other lights around. And I don't want any reflection. I'd like to be able to just see in as though it's a non-reflective window.
Gotcha. Thank you so much. You covered it great tonight. I really do appreciate it.
Good. Next week, we'll actually get on with the job. Thanks so much, Jeff. Cheers.
So thanks for watching. And we hope model railroading is still fun for you, including bringing your scenery to life with fiber optic lighting. Remember the slogan, lighting without wiring. It will put a smile on your face.